This almost started World War III. It's only fucking January.
Away from Tinseltown, Washington, D.C. has been consumed by real drama, Trump's impeachment trial. The president stands accused of pressuring a foreign power into investigating Hunter Biden, son of prehistoric concierge Joe Biden, who has a chance of challenging Trump in the November elections. But not everyone believes the charges have merit.
The whole impeachment thing was baseless, okay? So the Democrats claim that Trump pressured Ukraine into digging up dirt on the Biden family, and their only real evidence of that is a transcript of him doing it.
So what did he say on the transcript?
What transcript?
Well, you just mentioned a transcript.
Check your tape. I said no such thing.
You said the only real evidence was a transcript of Trump pressurizing Ukraine.
There's no such place as Ukraine.
Yes, there is.
I choose to believe there is not.
The Republican-controlled Senate votes along partisan lines. Trump is declared not guilty. And fabulous.
But this is what the end result is.
Trump refused to wear a mask for a long time. If someone told him white hoods protected against the virus, maybe he'd have felt differently.
Egged on by the president, some citizens also refused to toe the line.
Whoa! I thought I heard a voice. I thought I heard from America.
In several states, protesters take to the streets, demanding their constitutional right to spread the deadly virus.
When this whole thing started, there were so many wild rumors flying around. So I would watch Dr. Fauci to get an anchor on what was actually happening, you know? And even though it was so scary, I found it really reassuring to watch someone who is so accomplished calmly laying out the science. But that was before I knew he was an actor. Yeah.
And how did you come to learn that?
Well, someone from my PTA WhatsApp group shared a link to a documentary which proves that George Soros created the virus in a Chinese lab so that Bill Gates could make a vaccine out of microchips and control us all like we're in a video game. And I know that sounds crazy, but the thing is, we've seen him do this before, right? Like when he crossed a human with a paperclip and made that poor, tormented monster that haunted Windows 98.
Of course, it wasn't surprising that some folk were confused about the biology of this whole thing, given the president seemed to be saying it could be cured with a kind of sunlight and bleach wonder diet.
And then I see the disinfectant where it knocks it out in a minute, 1 minute. And is there a way we can do something like that?
The remarks confuse the president's own medical advisors, who visibly try to clamber deep within their own souls to die.
I guess if you could collapse the past 3.5 years of madness into one clip.
That would be it.
Some white individuals begin to ask whether they're doing enough personally.
Well, I consider myself an ally. You know, but I looked within. I felt I could make some changes. So I started small, posting the black squares on Insta. I swapped to only using black emojis for texts. I sent a lot of friend requests to black people, and I even learned how to pronounce their names, even if it was difficult.
Beautiful.
And then I thought, listen, look, I know I care, but do enough other people know that I care? And I realized I should up my game, so I posted a video about it. And so I guess, in a way, I'm black too. Maybe more than anyone. And that caught some likes, so we did a follow-up where I drove around a black neighborhood to let them hear my support in person.
Guys, I just want to say, right now, I'm with you. I hear you, I see you, I am you.
And you know, this wasn't just some quick little gesture. We kept it up till 2 a.m. That's how committed we were.
Friends of color, I stand by you. I feel your pain.
Go. It's just no pleasing some people.
With America facing crises on every front, criticism of the president is mounting.
also there were questions about his fitness to govern.
To boost support, Trump announces a series of rallies.
We've had a tremendous run at rallies. I don't think there's been an empty seat.
But despite a surge in ticket requests, an event in Oklahoma is mainly attended by people who aren't there.
TikTokers said they intentionally sabotaged the event by registering en masse with no intention of showing up, and they spread the word via TikTok.
Republicans claim social media is actively trying to suppress an unreasonable conservative agenda.
I'll just cut to the chase. Big tech's out to get conservatives. That's not a suspicion, that's not a hunch, that's a fact.
Look, the fact, which doesn't care about your feelings, is that online and in the media, conservative voices are being silenced. I've said this before. I said it on my YouTube channel. Conservative voices are being silenced. I said it on Joe Rogan. Conservative voices are being silenced. On the Jordan Peterson Kayak podcast, conservative voices are being silenced. I said it on Tucker Carlson. And Tucker, we know conservative voices are being silenced. Twice, actually. Like I said last time, Tucker, conservative voices are being silenced.
That is exactly right.
And I said it in my New York Times bestseller. Conservative voices are being silenced. It's a point I have to make over and over because conservative voices are being silenced. In fact, you won't even use this footage.
Actually, we will.
Bob, we both know that's not going to happen.
Yeah, my name is James.
Whatever, Bob.
There appeared to be swathes of Trump supporters protesting, but we don't know how many because they refused to let anyone count them.
With the counting lasting days, the networks are reluctant to make an official call. National fingernail supplies are chewed dangerously low.
This election was a done deal on night one, but it didn't feel like it because of the way the count was happening. Pennsylvania and Georgia were counting mail-in ballots last, even though those had been the first to arrive.
Finally, as Trump's hunched-backed lab assistant Rudy Giuliani addresses the media from the prestigious car lot of Four Seasons Total Landscaping, a call is made.
What was it called by? Oh my goodness, all the networks. Wow! All the networks!